My name is Sarah. As you may already know, fairy tales can change slightly with each retelling, and most fairy tales were originally much more violent than they are today. That is why it is so interesting to look at different versions of a fairy tale and compare them, and that is why I want to make a series of videos comparing different versions of fairy tales. The first story I want to discuss is an old French fairy tale called The White Cat. It is not a very common fairy tale in North America, so don't be startled if you haven't heard of it before. The original version was written by Madame de Lannoy. Please forgive me if I mispronounce that. I will be looking at four different versions, including the original version. The story starts out the same way in all versions. An old king has three sons, and he wants to give his throne to one of them, but he is not sure which one to pick. The old king gives them three tasks to see who should win the throne. 1. Find the smallest and most entertaining dog in the world. 2. Find a piece of cloth so fine that it fits through the eye of a very small sewing needle. And 3. Find the most beautiful princess in the world. The three princes split up to complete the tasks, and the youngest prince walks through an enchanted forest, where he finds a castle. The castle is run by a beautiful white cat, and the white cat helps the youngest prince with the first two tasks. For the third task, the white cat is transformed into the most beautiful princess in the world. But how this happens varies greatly with each version. The first version I am going to discuss is the version by Errol the Cain. In this version, the youngest prince brings the white cat back as his bride, and he formally declares that he will marry her even though she is a cat. Then she turns back into a princess, simple as that. Much of the story is heavily simplified, and the second task is even skipped. The illustrations have a very soft look to them. Overall, it seems this version was meant to be a children's bedtime story, rather than a detailed retelling of the original version. The second version I would like to discuss is the version by Eric Metaxas. In this version, the youngest prince goes to discuss the third task with the white cat, and he finds her very upset. The white cat tells the prince that she is engaged to an evil gnome who will shortly come to take her away. The prince fights the gnome to defend the white cat, and the gnome is winning, when the prince declares that he cares more about the white cat than his father's kingdom or even his own life. Apparently, evil gnomes have no concept of love, and the evil gnome becomes very confused and then shrivels into a husk. The white cat then turns into a beautiful princess, and everyone lives happily ever after. The wording and illustrations in this version really shine, and it is my personal favorite. The third version I would like to discuss is the version by Robert Sansucci. This version also has the white cat engaged to an evil gnome. The prince fights the evil gnome in a bloody battle, and eventually the prince kills the gnome. Then the white cat is turned into a large crystal. The prince brings the crystal back to his father, but the crystal slips and shatters, releasing a beautiful princess. This version is more violent than the previous versions I have discussed, and not quite as poetic. The fourth version I would like to discuss is the original version by Madame de Lannoy. This version was tricky to find, but eventually I found a very, very old copy. This version is the most extreme version, and contains very strong violence. So be warned. The youngest prince goes to discuss the third task with the white cat, and she tells the prince that she can get him the most beautiful princess in the world, but first he must promise to do exactly as she says. The prince agrees, and then the white cat tells him to cut off her head and throw it in the fireplace. The prince is horrified at first, but eventually he complies. Once this is done, the white cat turns into a beautiful princess. Now, in my opinion, This seems excessively violent even by the standards of old fairy tales, and this is definitely not a book I would read to a child. On the other hand, the rest of the book was very well written and had very nice illustrations, so I have mixed feelings about this version. Well, there you have it. 4 versions of The White Cat. All 4 versions were made available through the library. Otherwise, this project would likely not have been possible. I hope you enjoyed this video, and feel free to comment if you wish.